Maybe you're new to DM7 series, yet you know you're going to be using it on a job soon as they're rapidly gaining in popularity. So, let me help to get you started. What do you need to know, check and do before you start mixing with audio? If you've not met me before, thanks for watching. I'm Andy Cooper, and I've been a part of Yamaha's research and development team in the United Kingdom for over 20 years now. I'm very happy to give you some online training. We're going to run through the user setup and preferences, but let's start by checking if the firmware version is the latest. Touch the three lines icon at the top right of the fader bay screen. Select the setup menu and the general screen. See your version in the center and check Yamaha's website in case an upgrade is available. Firmware gets installed from a USB drive. While we're here, check the status of plus 48 volts phantom power. You may need to activate it for the Omni inputs on the rear of the console. Also, select your preferred language for the channel name characters. There's quite a wide range to choose from. Adjust the fan speed if the temperature is likely to change significantly. And adjust the brightness of the screens, lights, and LCDs. By the way, if the screen goes too dark and you can't see it anymore, press and hold home to return to the default setting. One more item to check on this screen is the delay compensation setting. In case you haven't come across this on a mixer before, it can ensure that all your input channels, output buses, and processing are time-aligned for more coherent mixing. By default, input inserts are compensated, so no matter what internal plugins and effects are inserted, they have the same latency. You can do the same for outputs in case they need to be blended later. And you can align output buses in case audio with different routing requirements need to be kept aligned. For speedy monitor mixing, keep them off. For coherent multi-loudspeaker front of house mixing, enable the compensation. Next, we should visit the word clock screen. The default word clock source is Dante 96 kHz. Even if there is no other Dante device connected, it's okay to keep this setting, as the console's own Dante module will be the source. Only change this if you have a specific reason, like needing to work at 48 kHz for compatibility with other equipment. Note, however, that changing to 48 kHz alters the latency as shown in the delay compensation screen. So you may prefer to upgrade everything else to 96 kHz. It's also worth visiting the date time screen and setting your time zone, date, and clock. This is used when storing scenes and saving files to USB drives. Now let's go back up to the user setup screen. Check the user level. If it shows administrator, then you have access to all functions. If it shows something else, then your access may be restricted. You'll either have to live with it or find someone with a password to help you out. Touch User Level to check the permitted operations. Assuming you have access rights, open the preference menu to determine the mixer's behavior in certain conditions. For example, how many confirmation messages you want. Auto channel select seems to be a feature people either love or hate. When it's on, the last channel you adjust or even touch the fader of becomes selected. Also, you might want to stop the selected channel from changing each time the fader layer is changed. Cue cell link is another common one to change, whether you want to always be seeing the channel you're listening to or not. In case you're wondering, panel assistance is where all the keys light up dimly when the brightness is turned down to help you operate in extreme darkness. And SOF means sends on fader. What function the on keys should have when sends on fader is activated. Finally, let's take a look at the surface settings, only available on the larger DM7. This determines how the two fader bays interact. Choose whether to link the cell keys so there's either just one selected channel across the whole console or a different selected channel for each bay. Link the bays if you want the fader layers to change together on each side. See 24 inputs or outputs at the same time, or switch to the custom or DAW layers together. Link the sends on fader to avoid any confusing situation where each bay is in a different mode. Though, if you're an experienced user, you may be happy to break that link. If there are multiple use cases for one console, use the memory banks to save the different settings. And that is all your preferences set. Now you're ready to move on. The custom faders use defined keys and knobs. You'll probably want to edit after having spent a bit of time operating and getting to know DM7 series. So let's keep them at their defaults for now. In the next video, we'll look at the bus setup and pairing channels. After that, we'll move into the patch menu and then the network for setting up additional control apps. Keep watching this channel and I'll be back soon.